Welcome to Money, 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 your weekly personal finance date with me, Surabhi Upadhyay. Now, this is the second week of our special series on insurance, that critical element that is a must in your PF plan, even before you start thinking about investments and wealth creation. Now, this week's focus is on health insurance, and my guest on the show is financial planning expert Harshvardhan Roongta. Harsh, great to have you back on the show. This is a subject that's really close to, you know, a lot of people, because increasingly with the way life has turned out to be and the way disease and illness has, you know, kind of engulfed us, unfortunately, hospitalization has become a reality. And that's when you really realize, are you covered or not? Do you have the adequate financial firepower to deal with that situation? So start by telling us the sort of products, I mean, that are in the market. We all know about Medicliam, but what is the right approach to health insurance?
Well, Surabhi, you've picked up a very appropriate topic. The reason being because we've seen that, you know, you mentioned about illnesses, you know, engulfing us. We've seen the kind of expenditure that a family incurs in case of any medical emergency and which could put the entire finances into haywire. Now, the question is, when you talk about health insurance, so there are a couple of different types of policies which are available in the market with different features, while the most popular one being, of course, Medicliam. So Medicliam is technically a product which is based on the principle of indemnity, which is nothing but essentially a product, says you've covered yourself for, say, 5 lakhs of sum insured. And in that particular year, if there is an hospitalization, the expenses as covered in the policy up to 5 lakh rupees will be reimbursed to you. So which means that first the expenditure has to be incurred, or at least the expenditure has to be identified only up to 5 lakh of rupees.
Right.
And that is based on actual expenditure. Now, there are other kind of health insurance policies also available, such as you have critical illness policies. Then there are major surgical assistance policies, and there are hospital daily cash benefit policies. Now, what do these features mean? Now, let's talk about critical illness, for example. Now, if you talk about critical illness, now there are certain pre-listed ailments, you know, in the policies, mentioned in the policy. For example, it could be a heart attack, it could be a renal failure, it could be a stroke, it could be paralysis, it could be cancer for that matter. Now, these are specified in the policy document itself.
Sure.
On the basis of diagnosis of these ailments, so if an insured is diagnosed of this particular, any of these ailments,
critical illness,
any of the critical illnesses, and survives a minimum waiting period, could be a 30 days, could be 90 days, he survives that period, a lump sum benefit as specified in the policy will be paid out to the insured.
Okay.
Now, this is not linked, this payout is not linked to your actual medical expenses.
Okay.
So, you could have, you would have to be hospitalized for that instance. Now, all your expenditure in the hospitalization, for the hospitalization will be taken care by Medicliam.
Let me actually stop you there to understand this. As you mentioned, about four types of health policies which are there, Medicliam being the overarching one, which we all know, and those in the private sector, a lot of the companies end up, you know, giving you group health insurance as well. People buy their own health insurance policies. Now, this Medicliam product, first and foremost, before we talk about critical illness, the coverage, let's say, might vary between, you know, a 5 lakh rupee cover to a 10 lakh rupee cover. But what all does the cover cover? And what are sort of the red herrings that one should be aware of, or that one should watch out for at the time of buying this policy?
Well, when you talk about the Medicliam policy, which is nothing but an hospital expenses reimbursement policy.
Okay.
So what it means is, if there are, if you've contracted with a particular ailment which requires hospitalization, and you are advised to undergo possibly an hospitalization or a surgery or any treatment while being inpatient in the hospital, then all the expenditures that you incur and which are covered by the policy are going to be reimbursed to you. Now, what is important here, there are some ailments which do not require hospitalization any further because of advancement in medical science.
Sure.
In those cases, you can also be reimbursed for all the expenditures. So those have to be recognized by the insurance company.
So those also can be covered under Medicliam.
Absolutely.
As long as you are very clear and aware of those terms when you're buying the policy.
Absolutely. So this is by and large the nutshell of what is covered. Now, there are certain exclusions which one must keep in mind.
Absolutely.
In case of any cosmetic surgeries, it could be plastic surgery for enhancement of a person's looks, that is not covered under Medicliam.
Okay.
Unless that plastic surgery was required if in case of an accident.
Accident or trauma, yeah.
So,
yeah.
So prima facie, it is not for rest cure. Like, you've been stressed out and you need to go and, you know, your doctor's advice you rest, means you admit yourself in a hospital, take rest. Well, that is not covered. There has to be essentially an ailment which has to be, which requires medical supervision and accordingly.
But what are the very important riders? Because we know that I don't get health insurance from day one of buying the policy, right? There are the waiting periods that kick in. Any important fine print that one should be aware of while buying Mediclaim, which as you're now describing is the basic, the first line of defense when you're looking at, you know, mitigating hospital expenses?
Well, there are two kinds of, the things that you need to keep in mind. The first is, as you mentioned, there's a waiting period. So for certain kind of ailments, we spoken about cataract, for instance. So invariably, when you buy a policy, the cataract surgery will not be paid for within one year of taking the policy.
Okay.
The idea being, because there is a possibility, you know, your doctor has advised you to undergo a cataract surgery, but you can postpone that for a certain amount of time. It is not an emergency in many cases. So in that case, a person may be advised to undergo cataract surgery, he buys a policy, waits for 6 months and then undergoes a cataract surgery. That is possible.
Sure.
So there is a waiting period for certain ailments,
which could be as long as 1 year,
which could be even 30 days, beginning with 30 days. Like, you can't make any claim within 30 days unless it is an accident or an emergency.
Okay.
Now, there could be certain planned hospitalizations which you could delay. So the insurance company knows about them. So they put a waiting period of, say, 1 year. In some cases, the waiting period could be some ailments specifically, could be even going up to 4 years. So there is a waiting period which has been included in the policy, which is told to you upfront.
And that's where the real debate comes in. I mean, the genuineness of a case of a real ailment or illness arising, as opposed to someone who's really planning it out and trying to be smart or rather outsmart the insurance company. Now let's come to critical illness, because that's another very interesting aspect that you brought up, where the lump sum is paid out the moment a critical illness is diagnosed. Are the premiums very heavy for this policy? What kind of covers can I expect? What sort of ailments are covered?
Well, when you talk about the cost of buying certain policies, it always has to be linked to the probability of that event happening. So say, for example, if I talk about critical illness by itself as a product. When we have critical illness as a product, the basic features of the policy simply say there are predefined ailments or critical illnesses. Now, if you're diagnosed of that particular illness, a lump sum payment will be made to you, irrespective of you going to the hospital or not going to the hospital. Now, if there are 7 ailments mentioned in it, then the premium is going to be higher as compared to a policy which covers only one ailment, for example. Mm-hmm. Now, take an example of a regular critical illness policy. A person buying a probably a 25 lakh cover under a critical illness would possibly cost about 12 to 15,000 rupees per annum, which covers about, say, 9 ailments.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you look at another policy available in the market which covers only cancer as an ailment, as an illness, it says that if you're diagnosed with cancer, I will pay an X amount. Now, the risk is concentrated to only one ailment in that case, to only one illness. So the same premium, which was about 12 to 15,000 rupees for a 25 lakh cover, will come down to possibly 3 to 4,000 rupees.
Okay, Harsh, so we've done two types of policies and there are several others. Apparently, you can buy health insurance for specific surgical costs. You can also buy a policy that takes care of hospitalization expenses beyond the Mediclaim. We're going to be discussing that and a lot more on the other side. Welcome back. You're with Money, Money, Money. And this week we are addressing a very, very important topic, health insurance. If you're not insured for health, then please listen in carefully. So Harsh, we've discussed the first line of defense, Mediclaim. You have to have it. We've discussed the second line of defense, which is the critical illness cover, which I think is really important given the way, urban lifestyles are changing. It perhaps is a very sensible move to have that cover. Now, what about the policy that specifically pays you out when you undergo surgery? And how does that make sense when you already have Mediclaim? Because Mediclaim would cover you for surgery, right?
Well, Surbhi, insurance companies have made tremendous progress in offering different kind of products. So while we've seen about Mediclaim that has specific reason why Mediclaim needs to be bought, critical illness needs to be bought because there is going to be a loss of productivity in case of diagnosis of any critical ailment.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you talk about these major surgical assistance and you talk about these surgical assistance policies, these are nothing but just a topping onto your existing products. Like, for instance, if you've taken a life insurance policy, mm-hmm. you've taken a term insurance life cover. Now, what happens is this major surgical benefit are probably as a rider attached to your policy rather than a standalone policy.
Oh, so they come as riders along with a life insurance policy.
Absolutely.
The surgical policy.
Absolutely. So the idea behind this is, in case you are required to undergo a particular surgery, there could be a possibility you do not have a Medicliam policy. So life mm-hmm. insurance companies recognize that part mm-hmm. and give you a top up. It says mm-hmm. that in case you're under, if you're required to undergo a surgery, mm-hmm. a fixed lump sum will be paid out to you.
Sure.
Irrespective of whether you have a Medicliam or no. So you okay. could have a Medicliam. Mm-hmm. which reimburses your actual costs mm. in case of these kind of products wherein a lump sum will be paid out to you. So this only goes in addition to assisting you with your regular Medicliam.
So now if you have this as a rider in your life insurance policy, great, well and good for you. But for those who don't have this as an add-on with their life insurance policy, does it make sense in buying a standalone surgical policy?
Not really. In fact, you should look at buying a comprehensive Medicliam policy for that matter.
Okay.
And increasing the cover there instead of buying a specific surgical benefit policy.
Okay.
So while if you think that there is a surgery that you're going to be, you know, required to undergo, and there are restrictions in your existing Medicliam policy, like there could be a room rent restriction which also restricts the amount that they pay out in case of a particular surgery,
mm-hmm.
in that case you may top it up with a major surgical benefit rider or a standalone policy.
Okay.
However, if the surgical cost is taken care and covered in your Medicliam, then you rather have that as a more comprehensive cover than you buying it separately.
Absolutely, and lesser paperwork to deal with, you know, fewer number of policies and insurance companies to deal with.
Absolutely.
What is the fourth type of health insurance policy now?
Now there are, when you get hospitalized, there are certain expenses which are non-medical in nature. Like there could be some food that you've called for, which is not a medical expenditure, so Medicliam does not pay for it.
Mm-hmm.
There are certain, you know, you could make telephone calls, or you may have used certain
transportation, etc.
Yeah, so there could be transportation, there could be mm-hmm. some other costs which are not technically medical expenditures, mm-hmm. but they are incurred while being in hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so in that case, there are some policies which also kick in another benefit to you, saying that the number of days you're hospitalized, an X amount will be paid to you.
And typically, what's the kind of sum assured over here, and how do the premiums range?
The benefit that we're looking at could be ranging from, say, possibly 1,000 rupees per day to going up to 4,000 rupees per day.
Okay.
So if you're hospitalized for a month, then it kicks in a substantial amount. But in sure. case you're hospitalized for about 2 or 3 days, then the amount of benefit is very less in that.
So this is not a standalone policy. Then again, is it a rider to a life insurance
Absolutely.
Policy?
So it is a rider in some Medicliam policies. It is included.
Okay.
And it is a choice upon the customer to avail of it, or it is a part of a life insurance policies which they club in.
Okay.
Because critical illness policies are also being sold by life insurance companies.
But critical illness is alone is available standalone as well.
Absolutely.
That's the important aspect, and one does need to consider buying it as a standalone product if you don't have it as a rider to your life insurance
Absolutely.
Policy. Now let's talk about an individual age between 30 to 35, because that's typically the ideal age to buy health insurance. That's when you'll find the most competitive product offerings, premiums are low, etc. So I'll give you my example. I mean, I'm paying typically between 6,500 maybe 7,000 as annual premium for a policy that gives coverage of around 5 lakh rupees. But I don't know if that's enough. I mean, looking at the way hospitalization costs are ballooning, if I want to increase the cover, what do I do? Do I just have to, you know, cough up more premium?
So how much is sufficient? Suppose in this example, I talk about buying a cover for 25 lakhs. Now, in that case, your premium commitment would go up to, say, 35,000 rupees per annum. Mm-hmm. And that is per individual.
That's
and
I'm sure it. Out goes my weekend trip. out go the movies and, you know,
Absolutely.
All the restaurant plans. Yeah.
And you're not the only person in your family that you would like to cover. Mm-hmm. So how much can you spend upon only just one particular, area of your personal finance?
Mm-hmm.
Now, interestingly, if I tell you that there is a combination available in which you can cover yourself for 25 lakhs, but instead of paying 35,000 as annual premium, you have to pay just about, say, 9 or 10,000 rupees per annum.
Wait, say that again. A 25 lakh rupee health insurance cover for a premium of around 9,000 rupees?
That's right.
Is that even possible, or am I hearing things?
No, it's actually possible. And this is because of the innovation that I said this country is undergoing, and insurance sector is making those kind of progresses. Now, what you would only have to do in this particular case is take two different policies. You continue with the policy which you already have, which is a 5 lakh base policy. So you mm-hmm. have a 5 lakh cover,
mm-hmm.
and we term it as a base policy for the moment. So this is your base cover.
Yeah.
Beyond this, you buy a 20 lakh super top-up policy.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a super top-up Medicliam policy,
okay.
which is for, say, 20 lakh of rupees, and for which the outflow in your case would be, say, about 3,000 rupees per annum.
So I'll have to take this policy from another insurance company,
another insurance,
because I don't
company.
Know if my insurer offers this super top-up option or not.
Absolutely. If okay. your current insurer insurance company offers you this possibility, you will go with the insurance company.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you can go and buy this super top-up policy from another insurance company
okay.
as well.
Okay.
Now, look at the scenario. You have a coverage of 25 lakhs for yourself in this particular case, and your outflow is, for the base policy, 6,500 rupees,
mm-hmm.
and for the super top-up for a 20 lakh cover is 3,000 rupees.
Mm-hmm.
So your annual outflow is 9,500 or 10,000 rupees.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you go about claiming? So you have a cover of 25 lakhs. Now, all the expenditures that you incur up to 5 lakhs in a year, which will be claimed by your base policy.
Okay.
So you have to make a claim with your first insurance company, which is your base policy provider. You go and make all the claims up to 5 lakh rupees in a particular year.
Okay.
Once you've exhausted the limit of 5 lakhs, only then the super top-up policy kicks in.
Okay.
And expenditures up to 20 lakhs, the next 20 lakhs after 5 lakhs, is covered by that policy.
So, well, hopefully you don't have to breach that limit and hopefully you won't require the super top-up policy, but you might definitely want to have it just in case. We'll take another break on that note. On the other side, the riders, the fine print, and everything else that you need to know, particularly if you're not in your 30s. What if you're somewhere in your 40s or 50s and are still thinking of buying health insurance? What are your options? We'll discuss that after the break. Welcome back. Here with Money, Money, Money. And this week we are discussing health insurance. So Harsh, you know, now let's talk about people who are not in their 30s, who haven't had the benefit of the information that we have right now. We know that we need to buy insurance early. But for mid-aged people who already have certain, you know, issues and ailments perhaps that have arisen, what sort of a policy can they go for? And if you could give a few names of where, you know, you think that the payout ratios are, you know, usually healthy, then that will be of good use.
Well, Subhi, when you talk about buying an health insurance or a Mediclaim for that instance, the insurance company wishes to know and requires to know whatever is your pre-existing ailments. So while you're filling up the proposal form, there are, you need to be very careful and fill that proposal form by yourself and make sure that all the declarations have been made properly in it.
Now, but that's the biggest worry, right? I mean, transparency is what, you know, a person always thinks of, that if I declare everything, will I get covered at all or not? Will my application be rejected or will my premium go up exponentially? And that's the big fear when you're going and buying health insurance, how much to declare.
See, well, I'll tell you, Surbhi, let's look at it like this. What is the purpose of insurance? Is it that you only need the policy document in your hand and you feel good about it, or you actually get the claim when you require it?
Absolutely.
So the idea is, while you may give any wrong information and get a policy document in your hand, it does not provide you the financial
security.
You won't
get the benefits. Yeah.
So at the time of claim, if the company finds out, which invariably there are various means under which they can find out, if they find out that there have been some, you know, misdeclaration or misrepresentation of vital information, then your claim is anyways going to be rejected. So the idea is, while you're filling up an application form, please make sure that all the details are very honestly declared. Now, we invariably come across situations where people ask us whether, you know, we consume tobacco, we smoke cigarettes, we consume alcohol, whether that should be mentioned in the proposal form. Well, if there is a section in the proposal form which is asking you for that information, you are required to fill it.
Sure.
Now, if you look at tobacco consumption or say, you know, smoking cigarettes, that is not an ailment by itself. It's an habit which could possibly trigger an health ailment.
Sure.
So the insurance company needs to know what is your consumption, but they cannot exclude anything relating to tobacco consumption as a clause in your policy.
Okay.
So go ahead and make that declaration, and as far as possible, try and recall if you've had any ailments in the past and mention it in the proposal form. Now, when you talk about people who are into mid-age and who've already contracted certain ailments,
I mean, things like hypertension, in fact, even diabetes is becoming so rampant and so common now. So then what are their chances of getting a decent, you know, health insurance policy?
So, well, you need to make an application, you know, based on the features of a particular product and apply with that company. Now, when you declare everything, the company comes back to you with a counter offer. So they may revert back to you saying that we're willing to insure you. However, we will not cover diabetes, any ailments arising because of diabetes.
Okay.
And if you're accepting that particular ailment, this particular counter offer, then you can get the policy, but diabetes related ailments will not be covered.
Okay.
Now there's a big debate. Everything could be related.
A lot of things are triggered because of diabetes, unfortunately.
Exactly. Yeah. So now this is something that you have to live with, because you know, at this juncture, you cannot have everything defined.
Sure.
Like every ailment could be invariably linked to diabetes going further. But however, there has to be some sanity in the entire process, and you need to, if you are already suffering with diabetes and your medication for hypertension, then you need to mention it.
I'm actually going to put you on notice here. You have to name a couple of products which you at least found where, you know, the payouts were decent, where the coverage was decent, maybe a couple of products that have really worked in your experience.
So, well, when we talk about Mediclaim for that instance, let's talk about certain features and the companies providing those features. So now, when we spoke about a situation which is a base policy, the Medicliam base policy of the 5 lakhs that we're talking about. Yeah. Now, in that, we've seen that there are certain public sector companies which have restriction on room rents. Mm. So, on the other hand, we have certain companies like, for example, a Tata AIG, Apollo Munich. These are the companies which do not have these kind of restrictions.
Okay.
Like, there is one set of companies, like, say, possibly a New India and other companies, which the payout for cataract is restricted to 24,000 rupees.
Okay.
In spite of your total sum insured being 5 lakhs. So, on the other hand, if you have a company which does not have those kind of restrictions, then you rather go in for those companies. And premiums are even lesser in those cases, when we have seen companies which are liberal in their features.
Mm-hmm.
So, when you talk about individual policies, I mean, I would give a thumbs up to possibly a Tata AIG MediPrime. I would talk about Apollo Munich Easy Health. You talk about these kind of policies which are very, very flexible and they have a good payout ratio as well. Then when you talk about super top up, I mean, mm-hmm. that we spoke about.
So the 25 lakh cover.
That balloons your cover to a total of 25 lakhs. So L&T General Insurance has a super top up policy. Okay. United India has a super top up policy. So you can consider policies between a private and a public sector. We've given mm-hmm. you both names. So you can check if you're, whichever mm-hmm. company you're comfortable with, you can buy a super top up policy with them. Mm-hmm. So this basically takes care of your Mediclaim in that particular context.
And critical illnesses, any suggestions or any advice on the kind of insurance providers to go for?
Yeah, so when you talk about critical illness, these fortunately are offered by both life insurance companies mm-hmm. as a rider and standalone, and they're also offered by general insurance companies.
Okay.
So within the general insurance space, Bajaj Allianz has a good critical illness policy. When you talk about as a rider, I mean, almost all insurance companies will give it as a rider to your life insurance policy. So if you're buying a term plan that mm-hmm. we talk about in life insurance, mm-hmm. you can take a rider which is critical illness and add it into
Does
your
Does it work
toddler.
Cheaper if you do that, if you take it as a rider to your life insurance policy?
No, actually, when you talk about the cost of premium, it would more or less be the same.
Okay.
What is more important is how many ailments are covered, how many illnesses are covered, mm-hmm. and what is the prerequisite of getting the claim.
Okay.
So you have to go into slightly into the features and go a little more deep into the product. Now we spoke about concentrated products which give payouts in case of any specific only one named ailment,
mm-hmm.
like for say cancer.
Cancer, yeah.
So HDFC Standard Life mm-hmm. has a policy which is cancer care. Now this is a policy which gives out a payment on the diagnosis of cancer only. So because the ailment is specified to only one, the premium is going to be less. So if I may have to say a 30-year-old, a male, female, the premiums for females are more because the incidence of cancers could be more in them.
Mm-hmm.
So a 40 lakh cover would come at about, say, 3,000 rupees per annum.
Well, it's hardly anything, I mean, given the kind of mental peace it can give you having all of these covers in place. Harsh, thank you so much for joining in and enlightening us on this very, very important subject of health insurance. Well, that's where we will take your leave, but our insurance series continues. And next week, we're going to be talking about your rights as an insurance policy holder. So do tune in for that. And of course, all feedback, comments and queries are welcome. Our email ID is on your screen. Thanks for watching.